Hey guys, Jordy here for Cinecom.net, and welcome to Creative Wednesday, I guess. Yeah, for the first time in Cinecom history, we missed an upload. Because, no, normally it's Tuesday, which was yesterday. And we didn't publish anything yesterday, and I feel really bad about that. It kind of hurts. Because it's also for a very stupid reason. We actually managed to have our video ready before 4 o'clock, but weren't able to press the publish button. I'm not going to dive too deep anymore into it. If you really want to hear the story, I've made an explanation video, which you can find in the comments of this video. Go check that out if you like. So if you don't care, you're just here for some nifty new tips, well then fire up Adobe Premiere Pro, because I've got 5 creative effects for you that you can use in your creative work. Let's roll the intro. Five unusual but very creative effects that you can use in any kind of creative work. And let's start off with the first one. From the effects library, I'm going to search for invert. Drag that effect to your clip. That's already going to invert the RGB channels and give you a cool look. But we can dive into the settings of this effect, and you can find different ways that the clip has to be inverted. What I definitely like a lot are the chrominance settings in here. Now, both of these will shift the colors in a trippy way. And this was also used in the music video Feels from Calvin Harris, which we also did a video about a couple years back. Next up is the paint bucket effect, which is gonna look weird when you apply it to your clip at first. So let's change a few settings within. With the fill point, which you can also drag around, you can choose which luminance value and color should be filled in with the paint bucket. After that, you can change the tolerance, choosing how much you would like to paint it in. Finally, there's a stroke option, which allows you to choose how the paint should look. Now, where is this useful? Well, you can create scribble effects with this. You won't have as much control over your scribbles as if you would do it manually frame by frame, but this technique does make it super fast. Now I just simply animated the tolerance to let my scribble effects come in and out. Now I've got 3 more exciting effects inside Premiere Pro, but first, a quick shout out to Storyblocks Video for sponsoring this episode. If you're looking for more effects, transitions, templates, animations, and so on that you can simply drag and drop into your favorite video editor, then definitely make sure to check out the Storyblocks library. Now, there are hundreds of thousands of video assets that you can download without additional fees. We've also been using Storyblocks for several years now and really love their library. We use it in many of our projects, and I can highly recommend to check it out too, which you can do by clicking the first link in the description below. Video effect number 3 is called Ambus. Now, applying that to your clip will make it look pretty weird. Now, basically, you can outline the edges of your clip and adding some sort of a relief to it. The options are very simple. You can play around with them to see what they do. Now, here's a great way to use the effect. Hold down the Alt key and drag your clip on a track higher to make a duplication of it. From the bottom clip, I'm going to remove the Ambus effect and only leave it active on the top clip. With the top clip selected, move over to the opacity property and change the blending mode to color. And this will turn your video into black and white, but because of the Ambus effect, it will add some sort of a RGB distortion around some edges in the shot. And this is a very stylish look for music videos, for example. You could also even animate the Ambus property to give some more life to those RGB glitches. The second blending that works pretty cool as well is soft light. And this will create the illusion that the video has some sort of a more three-dimensional depth. Here you can see an example without the effect, and here's one with the Ambus effect. And finally, I'd like to mention that you can also use the effect called Find Edges instead of Ambus. The technique works exactly the same, but it's going to give you a different result. This time, change the blending mode to either Multiply, Color Burn, or Linear Burn. And this will add a stroke around the contrast areas, which again could be very cool for music video effects. Moving on to the next one, we're going to search for Strobe Lights and drag that to one of our clips. Now, this effect is basically gonna flash white solids into your video. With the strobe duration and periods, you can change how much and how fast that should flash. You can also change the color to something else if you like so. Again, that alone could already be useful for a specific scene, but like before, let's take it a step further. You can change the strobe to make layer transparent. The strobe is now transparent, meaning that you can place another video underneath. And this looks pretty cool. Again, something that should work for music videos or maybe a flashback. Another cool trick is where you place the same clip underneath, but then without the strobe effect, and now I'm going to offset the clip underneath by a couple of frames. And now the video seems to have some sort of a time glitch, jumping back and forward in time. And that brings us to the last effect, search for the four color gradient and drag it to your clip. At first, it seems like a rainbow exploded, but we're going to change the colors of each point. What I'm trying to create here is a custom lens flare. So I look for orange, warm colors on one end. The brighter the colors are you pick, the more prominent they will become. So if you like a subtle blue leak on the bottom, for instance, I change the color to a very dark blue. You can also put some color points on black if you don't want anything to appear there. Finally, you can move the points to a different place if you like, or change the blend value, which will make them overlap and feather more. And now you can set the blending mode to screen or add to make them reveal on your clip. And if you like, you can animate the points in sync with the camera movement to let them fade in and out. And that's how you can create your own custom light leak or flare. I hope that you've learned something new and that there's maybe an effect in there that you can use on your next project. Thank you guys so much for watching. Thank you Storyblocks again so much for the support. And as always, stay creative.
The short movie's coming up and we need props. And one prop we need is the mask. And that I'm creating from scratch with some clay. I hope it works.